We have the four main demos, notebook 1 to 4. The notebook 0 is just a reference from SEALD and explain how we build all these blocks here and there, the acquisition data, image data, and data containers. And we'll start with Evelina that will introduce a little bit of tomography, run FPP reconstruction, and CGLS. Then we will go to Tikhonov regularization and introduce the block framework. Then we will run real data from the diamond light source, and then go to the PDHT and run a total variation reconstruction. In the afternoon session, we will do again total variation reconstruction for multispectral data by line work. So, Evelina, you want to start? Any questions? Okay.
Can you stop sharing?
Yeah. Do you want this?
Good morning, everyone. Can you hear me fine? Is it sound? Good morning, everyone. Can you hear me fine? Is it sound okay? So, I guess all of you can see this notebook structure on your screen. You can see that for every notebook, we have two versions. First one, notebook with exercises, and then we have another one with solutions. Please, if you're stuck, don't feel bad to just open solutions and take a look how you can solve the exercise. Oh, of course, you can ask us. So, for the first notebook, our learning objectives are to learn basic building blocks of the framework, then to set up FBP reconstruction. Also, we will learn how to set up iterative reconstruction on the example of CGLS algorithm. And also, we will learn how to visualize final and intermediate reconstruction results. In the first notebook, we will work on parallel geometry, the simplest one, the most straightforward one geometry, but we will learn more complex geometries in further notebooks. Also, in the first notebook, you can see that here we can set up device which we will use to run the notebook. If you are using Azure, you can use GPU. And it will be, of course, much faster than CPU. If you are using virtual machines for now, you need to change it to CPU. Also, as a default color map for all notebooks, we use gray color map. If you have other preferences, you can always change it to other color map you like. For the first notebook, we have roughly 40 minutes, and we will try to wrap in 35 minutes. And in the end of the first notebook, you will see two exercises. I would say that you don't, I added these exercises just to keep everyone busy, because some people will be go through notebook faster, some people will maybe need more time to learn different things. So if you can't finish both exercises, please don't feel bad, because first notebook, I would say it's rather too long for 40 minutes. So we will start now. It's 9:15, and we'll try to wrap up 9:45. Thank you. So how many of you have reached exercise part? more or less half of you. So, in the first notebook, just give me a second. So in the first notebook, first of all, we have learned basic building blocks of the framework, image data and image geometry and acquisition data and acquisition geometry. We also have set up FBP reconstruction algorithm. And I think some of you who have reached exercise part have noticed that FBP can perform very, very well on ideal noise-free acquisition data. But if we have very noisy data, reconstruction doesn't make any sense. For CGLS, I think you have seen that it performs much better with noisy data than FBP. But I think you have also noticed that depending on the number of iterations in CGLS algorithm, you can get quite different results. And it's always quite a tricky to predict how many iterations you need for CGLS. And you have seen that using algorithm class, using CGLS algorithm, you can check intermediate reconstruction results. And you can check how many iterations you need to get good reconstruction results. Also, if you reached the exercise part, you also maybe had a chance to set up reconstruction with a limited number of projections. And again, FBP couldn't really reconstruct data set from 50 projections, but CGLS still could give you quite reasonable reconstruction. In further notebooks, you will learn how improve reconstruction using regularization. And